I remember exactly where I was exiting the freeway, and I just thought, you know, pay attention to this. I think this might be something you like. And so I was packing up frantically, and I got to the airport with plenty of time. Weird. And I had time to sit and wait, and I just sat there and read the script, and I probably read it in an hour. And I just knew that it was, there was so much about Catherine that I loved and that I wanted to know what she felt like. I wanted to be her.
I'm sorry.
What's wrong?
Dr. Harris.
Yeah, and you're one of Dr. Stegman's, aren't you? What are you sorry for?
I've taken an interest in coma care. So I'm sorry I can't help his patient.
There was times I would look around at night when I was on the couch and I was alone, and I was just thinking about Catherine. And I thought, that's interesting. You know, I'm enjoying sort of thinking about her already. And then I came back from the holiday, and I told my agent I need to talk to Patty. And our first phone conversation, I knew. I immediately trusted him. I trusted his voice. I trusted how clear his vision was. I trusted the fact that he was willing to make changes, because that was really the one thing holding me back, was there were certain plot points I wasn't sold on yet, and I didn't believe. And I thought, we need a lot of work here. We need to work quick and fast to make this right, because the concept is there, but all the pieces are not put together properly yet. And as soon as I knew that, and I was just scared because I thought, if Patty is already okay with these things, then there's no room for improvement, and then it might not work. But he was on the same page that I was and wanted the same things changed and was listening to all of my sort of suggestions and ideas about Catherine, and I just got incredibly excited, and it was like, yes, this works. Everything you're saying works. Everything I'm saying works. It's just boom, 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 boom. And so I hung up the phone, and I was like, let's do this. And so from that point on, Patty and I had a couple more conversations as I'd go through the script and kind of work things through and come up with some backstories. And then before I knew it, 2 weeks later, I was in Ireland, and we were in pre-production, and I was meeting the cast. And oh, that was the other thing. They told me the cast was primarily going to be a British, Irish, and Scottish cast. And I thought, okay, now I'm sold. I mean, not that I don't like working with American actors, but I just thought, my God, to be in Ireland, working with someone like Patty that I already trusted, working on a character like Catherine that I've already fallen in love with, and then working with a cast that is really classically trained and has done some phenomenal work, but most of that work is in theater, and wanting to know what it would be like to work with them and see what they're going to bring to the table. And the power, I felt a sense of power. I felt like it was going to be a power cast. And my God, I was right. I mean, there's like no weak links in this cast.
They found him in the storeroom. Half his fucking head was melted.
I'm scared.
Come on, one thing's got nothing to do with the other.
What if this has something to do with Kenneth?
Want to say his name a bit louder? I don't think the cops in the next precinct heard you.
Yeah, you might want to ease off the hooch a little, Kim.
Screw you, Steve.
Oh, fuck, I'm sorry, okay? But we don't want to lose it. We weren't the only people Sean partied with. He kept bad company.
What about Yoshimi? She never did anything.
Yeah, but there isn't any mystery there. We know who killed Yoshimi, okay?
Yeah, but what do you mean, Kim?
I'm just saying, what if somebody knew and they're punishing us?
Like who?
I don't know.
Until a few days ago, they were ready to turn off his machines because nobody gave a rat's ass. And what now, out of the blue, he's got some kind of avenging angel? Christ, Kim, give me a fucking break.
All right, that's enough. This isn't helping, okay? It's weird, and it's all screwed up, but it is not connected.
Hey, Kim, maybe it's Creepy Kenny. The all-singing, all-dancing, all-sleepwalking, coma-killing vegetable. How about that, princess?
Well, you know, the other thing I love about Patty, the way that he shoots is sort of that, like, I think it's sort of what every actor dreams of, the way that they would want themselves to be shot, in an incredibly selfish way, because it's all about the close-ups and the eyes and the minor lip movements and the side shots of the hair spinning when you're turning, and all of those things that you sort of, I don't know, when you first think of becoming an actor. You think, how cool would that be? But it never really happens that way. And he shoots that way. And so I think for me, it was so cool to see that he was really telling the story. I mean, he never broke. He told me from the beginning he wanted to tell the story through my point of view. So you always had a sense that you were learning Catherine's discoveries as she was discovering them. And you were always following her through her eyes in the story. And I guess I liked hearing that, but it wasn't until I was seeing some of the shots that I really got it. And then that made me want to work twice as hard, you know, because it's like, okay, there's no bullshit here. You know, you can't lie to the camera, and it's right here. And it's such an empowering shot, and it's such a special shot, and it's such a special opportunity. You know, I really wanted to make it the best that it could be.
They're switching Kenneth off tomorrow.
Thank Christ.
Jesus, Sean. What is it with you?
What? Too much, Sean.
You okay?
I don't know, Kim.
Wait a second. Have you talked to someone about this?
We should have helped him.
Thrillers are tricky because you have to, in about 20 minutes time, you've got to make the audience believe you are exactly who you say you are, because the rest of the film is meant tracking a journey of scares and thrills and, you know, resolving the problem. And so you don't have a minute to lose. And they didn't. I mean, they performed to the fullest. And I told Martin it's not fair because the audience is probably going to love him a lot more than me, because he's on paper, he reads it just like the classic Dick. But in real life, he made Sean like so funny and fun that I was like, oh, great. American girls are just going to love him.
So I guess getting people wasted is the only way you can get them to do what you want.
Hey, if that's how you want to justify a night of passion, that's up to you.
I don't remember any passion.
Don't worry, I do.
Just go fuck him up.
Hey. It's been a type of role that I've been craving for a while. And then you combine that with, she's just such a special girl. I mean, she's got a harmful backstory. She's got the wits and the smarts and the brains battered to become a doctor. And yet she's got this underlying strength where at the end she is able to transform and work through all of the fear and the pain and everything that Kenneth has done to her and her friends, and you know, become the Sigourney Weaver of aliens. And it's just like, I mean, let's just say it. That is what it is. Like...